mixed signals for the Texas economy. The first on this day after the body was discovered in a wooded area near Lake Louisville, there was a crowd of mourners and some peculiar memorials to the dead wrestling star. Channel 8's Matt Quinn reports.
At the funeral home in Louisville this afternoon, perhaps 100 mourners waited for Doris Adkisson to finish saying goodbye to her son. When the fans and friends emerged from a brief stroll past a closed casket, their grief was evident. Not impaired by the ruling, if they knew of it, that Mike Von Erich was dead of an overdose of Placidil, a powerful tranquilizer. At the sportatorium tonight, among the fervent followers of the Von Erichs, there was a sad but blunt disappointment in the 23-year-old Von Erich who had let them down.
Oh, yeah. All the kids that look up to him, you know, there's so much drug problem going on as it is, they're going to think, well, that's the way I can go out, too. It's not good.
They rang the bell 10 times for Mike Von Erich and remembered 2 dead Von Erich brothers in one breath. And finally, words from Kevin Von Erich, scheduled to wrestle tonight.
We sure everyone is sorry for the death of our family. The last few days is really tough. I'm sure everyone here will understand why I'm not able to wrestle tonight.
And then life went on with a plug for a match still to come.
Let me tell you this. Come to Texas Stadium on May 4th.
But there were no answers to questions like, where and why did Mike Von Erich get the drug he died of? And what is the definition of his death? Accident or something else? No answer to that. Matt Green, Channel 8 News.
Well, this was...